What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about upgrading to Windows 11 23H2 using Intune. I'm having so much fun dealing with Intune, super easy. So let's get right into it. All right, so the first thing that we need to do is log into your Microsoft 365 Admin Center. On the left-hand side, we're going to click on Show All. And from here, we're going to click on, I believe, Endpoint Manager. It's going to load this up. And on the left-hand side, let's click on Devices. It's going to take you to the Devices Overview. We're going to click on Windows. And within the Windows section, we're going to find and locate and click on Feature Updates for Windows 10 and later. So click on it. It's going to take you here. We already created a profile a while back together, pushing out 21H2 to our machines. But today it is all about 23H2. So it's the same process. So we're going to click on Create Profile. We're going to give it a name. You are able to give it a description, but it is up to you. Microsoft is nice enough to automatically set Windows 11 version 23H2 default as the option, feature update to deploy. That's what we want. Awesome. It also gives you an option to enable if a device isn't eligible to run Windows 11, install the latest Windows 10 feature update. By default, that is not checked off, but if you want to, you could check that off. And the rollout option, the default is make the update available as soon as possible. So once you're done here, let's click on Next. For assignments, we're going to click on Add Groups. I'm going to select my group, so whoever's within this security group will automatically get the feature update pushed out to it. Click Select, click Next, a nice little review, click on Create, and on the upper right-hand side, you're going to see Windows Feature Update Deployment Successfully Assigned, Windows Feature Update Deployment Successfully Created. Awesome. And there goes our new profile. It's that simple. Now, within my lab, it took between an hour to two for the feature update to show up. And then that's an additional maybe 45 to an hour for it to download and another, I would say, 30 minutes for it to install. So the process does take some time for it to push down to your machines that are being managed within Intune. So that's it. Hopefully you guys enjoy this video, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.